Hey campers!
I am Shyla Youngs and my pronouns are she, her, hers.
And I'm Sophie Youngs and my pronouns are also she, her, hers.
Before we get started with the craft that we're going to do, we wanted to tell you a little bit about our camp history. So Shyla and I have been going to OGR for the past 8 years as campers, and we have also been volunteering the past 3 years as instrument instructors and band instructors.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
Yeah, it has. Today we are going to show you how to make musical anklets. The finished product will look a little something like this. It's a fun little craft that you can use as an instrument or just have fun to dance around with. To make the musical anklet, you will need felt, any color really, and then scissors, string, needle, and then glue, and bells and jewels. We want you to learn how to express yourself and be creative with this craft, but most importantly, have fun. You can personalize this craft a lot and make it your own, and we want you to try to really do that in this.
Yeah, which is really cool because it's so like versatile.
And that has always been a big part of camp, and to bring that online and be able to do it to you guys is really cool. So the first thing we are going to do is cut the felt. So me and Shyla chose to do white. So basically you just cut it in half from what like the normal felt size would be. Super easy, just cut it straight on the middle. And then the next step is to fringe the felt. So basically what that is to cut little slits into the felt, and you wanna leave about an inch on top so it's still together and you have room to thread in the bells and string. You want them to be thin but not too thin. So just like this. This is what the first two strings look like, and then you are just gonna do that all the way down. This is what the finished fringe product will look like. Yeah, super cute. And then after you're done fringing it, you're going to take a needle and thread. You can take any color of thread. We decided to do yellow for today. And you won't need a lot of thread, but we just kinda estimated on how much we think we'll need. So we did like about a wingspan, like your wingspan. But this is a really important part. So you're gonna take the end of the thread and put it in the needle in the little hole, but you don't wanna tie it because you're gonna need to take it out when you put bells on. So you kinda just hold it down here when you thread through. So you're gonna start by putting it in. And then you just pull it through. And you want to leave a little string on the side. So at the end you can tie it. So I left about that much, yeah. And then I'm gonna do one more. So you skip a little spot, but you come in from the same side and you go to the other. And then this would be the time where you string on a bell. But see how that looks, how there's that little yellow? But then, here's where is also another really important part of making these bracelets. So you're gonna wanna take your needle off and set it on the table. Okay, so then this is the time when you take one of your little bells and string it through on the string. And you wanna make sure you put your bells all on the same side because your bell should be facing outward from your ankle, but this is what it will look like. Super cute. And then when you're done stringing your first bell, you put your thread back through your needle, and then make sure to grab that little part down here. You don't tie it, remember? And then you're just gonna wanna go back in. So this is honestly the hardest part of making the whole anklet, but after this, it's just like really easy. This is the hardest step to do. This is what the first one looks like. And then you can put however many bells you want or space them out however you want. But the only things are to remember is to not tie a knot, to so you can be able to take it off and string your bell on, to know where to come back in to weave it through. And yeah, but we are going to finish this and then we're gonna show you the product. Like with all the bell string through, we were able to add 4 of them. And we actually ended with a lot of extra string over here, but that's a really easy fix. You can just cut it.
Yeah,
super easy.
So remember, you still have to leave a little to tie it. So I leave about that much, cut it. You could throw away your extra string. But then you're gonna come and bring these two strings together. You can pull it to like
what?
Fit your ankle.
Yeah. And basically you're gonna tie it like you tie your shoe.
In a little bow tie. Mm-hmm. This allows you to be able to undo it and do it again.
Yeah.
So you can take it off. And that way you can reuse it without having to make a whole new one.
Yeah.
What that looks like up close. A little bow tie.
Cute.
And then this would fit on your ankle. And then the final step, which you don't have to do, but I just want to do it to personalize my anklet, which is the big part about being creative.
Yeah.
We have these little jewels.
I don't know if you can see them, but they're really cute.
So basically all we need to do is glue these on, and you can add however many or however little you want. I just want to like personalize it my own cute little way, so. Okay, so basically you're gonna take a little bit of glue, put it on whichever jewel you want, and then you're just gonna stick it on your little anklet wherever you want it to be. So I'm gonna put it on this little strand right here. And then after you are finished gluing everything down, we advise waiting 10 to 15 minutes to let the glue dry and make sure none of them fall off.
Yeah, and that's what it's gonna look like when you like glue one little thingy on.
Here's the final product. I just glued some of those little jewels on.
And just remember, you can add littler than this or more than this. Just make sure to customize it and make it your own and be creative during it, because that's what's really important about it, is to express yourself through this little anklet.
And you can hear how the bells make sound. So when you're moving and walking, it'll make a ton of cute sounds. Mm-hmm. Thank you for spending time with us. We hope you had as much fun making this craft as we did.
Bye. Bye.